Hello, everybody. It's Ewa. We are at the Knitting Factory in New York, and we have some songs for you guys. Are you ready?
Allah wa bi abaka adaiki. Hassan. Yalla ya Adi Mashan.
Wonderful, you guys sound amazing. Your harmonies are incredible. Everyone's commenting about how lovely you're doing. I just want to shout out a couple of questions here. Catherine Petty asked if you can describe the meaning behind the first two songs you've sung so far.
Yeah, the first song, we talk about love, that it's like a fire that burns you from the inside, and there is no doctor that can heal you from this kind of strong love. And and the second one is more a happy song that we call God and say, please
bring us together,
bring us all together, bring my love from the other city in Yemen, that we can be with all the jama'ah, all the group, all the people, all the friends.
Wonderful. And you've mentioned this earlier, but some people who joined in late are asking, Sam Ben asking where you guys are from and how the group kind of came to be.
We are from Israel, Tel Aviv, and we sing Yemenite music. So our grandparents came from Yemen. So we mix the Yemeni folklore with more influences that we have, like hip hop and electro.
Melvin Donaldson says, what is the defining part of music that makes it Yemenite? Is it harmonies, beats, or the songs themselves?
It's the songs themselves and the dialect.
The dialect, also the groove. There are certain rhythms that are coming from Yemen. And yeah, I think it's the groove. And the language, yeah, like you said, yeah. The harmonies are totally Western element that we added, inspired by Motown singers and what else, from jazz.
Boswell Sisters.
Yeah.
Awesome, cool. Yeah. Skylar Nguyen is asking how long you've been singing together and how you met. Obviously, you're all related, but...
Practically,
we met in our parents' house.
Yeah.
In the living room. This is how we started making music together. Yeah. We were just performing to our parents in the living room, drumming on everything
possible.
Yeah.
And then at school, and then we went to college and studied. I studied music, and Tagel studied design and illustration.
Right.
Yeah.
And we had vocal lessons.
Yeah.
Piano.
Yeah, we all took theater class, ballet, piano lessons.
Allison Smith asks, what do you hope people will take away from seeing you perform live?
That's a good question. Just to, can I ask?
Yeah, sure.
Just to enjoy the music and forget about everything, like anything else, just... be in the moment.
To be empowered, how can I say? And to feel comfortable and free to just, like Leon said, to just be in the moment and dance and have fun with us, and in a way celebrate life and everything that you are. Because we always say that we wear many identities. We are women, we are sisters, we're Yemenites, we're Israelis. So it's okay to just be who you are and celebrate life. So we want people to take it, this message of love and empowerment.
Great. And Shira Daniels is asking where you're performing tonight, and maybe you can talk about where people can catch you in the coming months.
Hi. Tonight, we're in the Knitting Factory, New York.
It's a really cool venue here.
Yeah. And this is Yogi, by the way. He's from our band, Yogi Bluesman. And we're going to be performing here and tomorrow
in Pennsylvania?
No.
Philly.
And then check out the Facebook. It says everything that we can't remember. And then LA on the 25th. And for the next month, we're going to go back to Israel and to Europe. So check out the Facebook. It says everything.
Awesome. Well,
we'd love to see you.
Great. We're getting requests to go back to singing. So do you guys want to sing a final song for us?
Yeah, let's do it.
La 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 la
Thank you so much.
Thank you, guys.
Bye.
Bye. We love you.